Dear friends, here in this video, I will discuss about the plagiarism. The title of this presentation is What Your Plagiarism Report Says. Plagiarism is what? Plagiarism software is basically providing you a hint that you are not giving the credits to the original source. This is the only point of this discussion. I will discuss it in a systematic way so you get the idea. First of all, that plagiarism software sources, what about it? Actually, the algorithm of this software is that it read all the synonyms of a particular word. You may have seen into the dictionary that when you type a single word, it basically provides all the similar words. And second thing about to the database, all the research articles, books, proceedings, newsletter, audio, video, and websites references are included into that. Those things which are available online are listed with this software. So here I will explain those things, that this plagiarism software contains all the online information, and if you are using the synonyms of that a particular word and idea remains same of a sentence, then also plagiarism software provide a report. Why plagiarism? In a simple word, I can say that you did not cite the exact reference in your text. This is the only thing that plagiarism says. So how to avoid the plagiarism in your report? The simple thing is, and the first main important is, provide the credits to the original source. And that basically credits you know in terms of the citation. Right? So if this thing is clear, then you will never get the plagiarism in your scientific report. The second point is about to the relevant reference. What is it means basically here, relevant references? Right? So if you are not using the proper reference in your content, then also this plagiarism software tells you that this line or these words are not relevant to this particular source. The third one is the citation style. Citation style basically include the information, include the bibliographic information like name of the author, title of the research paper, the volume number, the issue number of the journal, right, and the year in which that research paper or article or information basically published online. Name of the source, it may be a website, it may be a book, proceeding, and the journal. And if you are extracting the information from the website, then you have to write the date of extraction, the date on which you have basically collect the information. Number five, note down every information and source. When you read anything for the information of your research work, then note down every information and source. Like information, like as I have discussed at number 4 point, right? And the source, it is a website or it is a journal, book or proceedings like that. Sixth number, don't do copy paste practice in references. And number seven, paraphrasing. This paraphrasing is what? I will show you this report of paraphrasing, that how basically some tools can change the meaning of actual sentence. And by this way, what happens? The actual meaning of the sentences in terms of the signs also change. At number eight, collect and list only authentic related work papers that I had discussed at the second, third point. At number nine, read and understand papers. Cite at right place and the right paper. This is the only important thing. By this way, you can avoid the plagiarism. So plagiarism is nothing. Plagiarism tells you that you are not using the right source for the citation, and you have to learn it. So here the example of paraphrasing, actual meaning of the sentence is changing, and in some sentences they are using the different words. So here we train the people in this way, in the paraphrasing tool. What that says, we educate the humans on this manner. At the third one, we educated the human beings on this manner. So from this line you can take the idea that how basically the paraphrasing tools or the people change the language. So here technical writing skills are required. Yes, understanding of some technical points are required, right, which I had discussed in the earlier slide, where I was saying that how one can avoid the plagiarism. So basically these are the technical points. The next question, should we take external support to write the scientific draft? Never. If you are a regular researcher, if you have used original source, if you are working on original problem, never take external support to write the scientific draft. So these were some points. I think this may be helpful to you for writing a research article or research project or any other essay. If you will follow these points, I am sure that plagiarism software will not tell you that you use this as original source, right? So these were some points. If you have any question, you can ask. So thanks for watching this video.